Alright, what is going on everybody? It is Tristan. Today in this video, what I got going on for you guys is we're just going to be discussing a pretty simple shoe right here. That's the Air Jordan 1 prototype. I'm not really a huge fan of this one, but there's a little bit of money on it. If you're trying to buy this shoe to make some money, then there you go. I'll pretty much be discussing how you guys could get it. I feel like it'll be much easier to get compared to most releases. Like a manual user will have more of a chance of getting this one even off foot sites and stuff like that. So we'll get into discussing all that if you're interested in it. So I hope you guys will enjoy. If you want more videos like this, feel free to subscribe and like down below. Again, no goal in this video. I don't really put one ever. Just, you know, road to 50K as I said. And I appreciate the, we hit 7K on Instagram. I don't know if that'll stay. I'm sure some people unfollow, follow, etc. But I appreciate it because we hit it. So I didn't even notice that. So I definitely need to post something. As I've mentioned the last few times, once we hit 50K, I'm going to be posting something guaranteed, just some sort of giveaway or something. So yeah, you guys will see me on Instagram again. I've just been kind of MIA, you know, not really posting anything. I'm not a huge fan of it though, just to be honest. So yeah, that's really everything I have to say. So yeah, let's just get into discussing this shoe right here because there's nothing really too crazy about it. Just subscribe and like, stay tuned. That's really the only thing. So first thing is here, it's retailing $170. It's normal Jordan 1 retail, and it's also dropping September 24th at 10 a.m. Eastern time. Now, I wanted to make this release after the exclusive access had happened, and I believe that happened yesterday, if I'm correct, if not the day before. So knowing that that had happened recently, now the only places where this will be dropping is just officially on sneakers, which again, 24th, 10 a.m. Eastern time. So just, you know, make sure you check on the app, see what time it's dropping for you, see the day, you know, if you're getting this release, all the details of that. You know, just make sure you're watching this video for releases you'll actually get. I just want to make sure nobody's, you know, not, you know, everyone's on the page. I don't really know what I mean by that. But yeah, to say the least, this one's also only dropping in adult sizes. I don't see any grade school sizes or anything like that on the site I've been checking. Or you can even just go here and sneakers, scroll down. There is none. It's just the adult sizing. But I can see why people like this shoe. There's a couple extra details, you know, which I mean, I feel like they're pretty nice. And the colorway isn't too bad. It just, this shoe would have been a lot better if they did not put the black sole and also this right here in the shoe. If they'd put like maybe just kept it gray here or something like that, then yes, this shoe would be going for a lot more money. But they put colors that don't really match. Like you don't put this blue, like a light blue and black together. You don't do it. It just doesn't match, you know, in my opinion, at least. You know, shout out my boy Ian Joseph. If you're watching this video or watching any of my videos somehow, that man knows his color coordination and stuff like that. He put me onto that because I used to wear like navy and like what, like black shoes, terrible fit. No offense to anybody that does that, but yeah, to say the least, it's hard to pull off a fit like that. And this shoe in particular, I just feel like I gotta keep it real. I just feel like it's ugly. It's ugly. That's what it is. That's just how I feel. If they'd really kept it gray and maybe left the sole like a white, or you know, maybe they could have left the sole black, just something different than what it is right now. I feel like it would have been a lot better. Maybe even making the sole like blue, like this blue up here to match that. I mean, come on, that would have been pretty cool. I have some good ideas Nike put me on, you know, but say the least, we'll just kind of hop into discussing resale for this shoe, or just kind of, you know, what I think about this, what sizes you should go for, since again, some sizes are not going to be reselling on drop day, I can guarantee you that, and this is not a hold at all. So really just get into that, discussing this. If you look at what it's going for right now, again, this is before the sneakers release. There's been plenty of raffles for the shoe, so that's why you can see any sales for this, but it looks like the bigger size you get, the more you will profit, but I wouldn't recommend going for any bigger size than a 14. That's just what I'm going to say. A 15 will be pretty hard to find a buyer unless it's straight through StockX, and this is the lowest ask, but is there anybody even bidding for it? I mean, yeah, okay, looks like someone actually bought a pair for $290 in a size 15, but the range of sizes I will be going for will be 10.5 and plus. That's just kind of where I feel like it'll be safe, to where I at least will get my money back, if not some sort of profit on it. If you want to guarantee profit, then anything above an 11.5, that should really be your goal, because again, I think these ones will probably drop another $10 to $20 once they release everywhere that they're on. Just kind of look at what the chart's at right now, or what the prices are at, not the chart, but yeah, just kind of see what they're at right now. Just expect them to drop whatever you see, another, you know, $20 you could say, or maybe another $10, whatever that is. That's what I think. So again, safely, to say the least, you should just go for the ones that are above 200 right now. So like anything above an 11.5 or above an 11 will probably get you some money. But if you're looking just maybe to build some FLX points like locally, you should definitely pick up this shoe, because I think there is some reservations going on for this shoe. Maybe there is, maybe there isn't, but I'm pretty sure Foot Locker and, you know, Finish Line, Champ Sports, Foot Action, all those typical places are doing raffles for the shoe. So if you want to go enter in those, do it, because you still should pick up shoes that don't really resell too well. when you get the chance and you win a reservation, because that's going to help you out in the future. When you pick up your reservations, it's a good thing. And also, the more points you have, the more you hit on Foot Locker and stuff like that. That's usually how it is. Unless it, again, is one of those bigger releases, you know, like something that's a good example, the Jordan 13 Obsidian, that one that's just dropping. That's a perfect one to just pick up because it'll probably resell for what it's going for, and or its retail price or a little bit more, and it'll get you some points, a good amount. I think like 19,000. It's good. So yeah, that's really everything you need to say there. If you understand that, then there you go, some info. But I kind of went off topic, so if y'all just want to kind of know again how to get this one off the sneakers app, the basic details to that, then I'm going to link these two videos right here down below this one right here. This is just one that shows you all how to make more accounts and sneakers, stuff like that. So if you don't have multiple accounts and sneakers, you're definitely missing out, because that's definitely how you hit more on releases, having more than one account. That's at least what I've done. I know people, you should at least have two. That's just kind of my opinion. Because Nike really can't tell too well, at least on who has multiple accounts or what's like a fake account or real account. They really have a lot of trouble identifying that, and I definitely know that because I see people that hit crazy amounts of pairs and sneakers, and that, you know, always kind of look into what they do, and I always, you know, use that advice to try to give it to you all. I have my own advice I'd use. I'll have another video coming soon, not this one, because I mean, the way to make multiple accounts hasn't really changed or anything. Like, this is still relevant today, so I don't have to change it. So yeah, that's the same. But this right here, I definitely have to update this video kind of, and you guys have shown a lot of love in it, so thank you. But this one right here, just one kind of shows you some tips and tricks to use on sneakers, and there's been some things that have definitely changed. I gotta go mention them in a video soon, so I'll definitely try and do that. But as I've also mentioned again, don't forget this shoe is dropping on websites, foot sites, you know, so like Foot Locker, those typical places that, you know, have shoes. This one is releasing this pair here. So I also want to give a huge shout out to my guys right here at Secret Sauce, because they could help you cop this release off foot sites. And I've of course explained them in tons of videos. You know, they're $60 monthly fee. You guys probably know that by now if you've been here. And you know, the amount of help that these guys have provided for me is crazy. Of course, I've always, you know, they have some like really good, you know, buy, sell, hold calls for shoes in their chat. If you're just trying to check that out, but also they have, you know, their whole slots and ticket section in their chat that can actually help you cop PS5s, maybe Wave Runners. Again, they had those for the Wave Runners that dropped today on the Yeezy Supply. They had some tickets for those. And also, you know, again, I think I've already said this, but PS5, I've made a lot of money off those, and they always have those or tickets running for those. So that's pretty nice. And those are easy profit because, of course, you know, it's still hard to get one. You still can't cop a PS5 manually. And that day will eventually be a couple years down the line, maybe. Who knows? But yeah, that's really everything I need to say about that, other than how it really worked, like how you would enter in a ticket in this chat and really actually cop a release like this, is once you're in the chat, they have this section again. It's the ticket section in their chat, and basically it shows you all the different ones that got going on. I've kind of explained again all the different ones that they run for. It could be sports cards, PS5, shoes, and how to enter in a ticket. It takes you to a Google form, whatever ticket it's for, and then you just got to put your shipping and payment info. I do this every week, never had an issue, been 100% safe, and they've helped me cop a lot of releases, a lot of different items. Again, most of the money I've made off this chat has not been directly related to shoes. I've gotten a lot of pairs of shoes, but a lot of the stuff has been kind of, you know, random items that have been reselling and different, you know, kind of items that they provide, raffle wins, things like that. Like, I've definitely been slacking on entering in raffles lately, so I need to get back to doing that because they have a really good raffle monitor. So if you want to check them out, check out their chat, just send them a message on Twitter, let them know that I sent you, or just, you know, go follow them on Instagram, and just wait until they drop invites again. So that's really everything I need to say. And yeah, just go give them a follow. I appreciate you guys as always, and they'll be there in the description if you want to check them. But also, a few more things I want to mention. I always mention these in my video too, and I notice I've been pretty repetitive with my words. I don't know why I keep repeating them, but yeah, to say the least, if you want to check this article here, a lot of raffles have already happened for the shoe, as I've said. There is still a couple going on, so if you want to go check this out, feel free to go enter in this. I feel like a raffle win will be pretty easy for the shoe, and there's plenty probably out there for this one, so this will be down below. And then also this article right here, I'm going to link the House of Heat one. The shoe looks cool, but I just, they should maybe left the laces white and then kept this part gray. Could y'all maybe agree with me on that? I don't know. I feel like the shoe just, it's so close to being good, but it just isn't. I feel like a lot of people may be able to relate to me on this release. It is so close to being good, but it isn't. It just, they missed. But I'm not even mad because they tried, and the shoe almost was good. Almost was good. You know, it looks decent. Not really, but you know, some parts of it, I kind of like the concept. But yeah, to say the least, plenty of places releasing the shoe, plenty of raffles, plenty of places releasing this one at 10 a.m. You can see there's a fair amount of stock for this release. And I just wish it looked a little bit better, because the shoe, almost a personal, but just missing on this section right here. Just, I'm not feeling it, the sole. It's just a few things off about it, in my opinion. So to say the least, I'm not going to link this one down below. It just has the same info as the House of Heat article. So yeah, we'll just kind of hop into the outro right now. Same things as usual. So you know, if you want to check my Instagrams, any of that down below, those will be in the description. So feel free. I appreciate you guys' constant support. And if you have any questions, leave them down below. I'll be there to answer them. I've been pretty busy lately, but yeah, you know, I will be able to help you all out pretty soon. I'll respond to comments as fast as I can. I usually try to do that. So yeah, just stay tuned, subscribe, like, no goal, no nothing, just 50K. That's the goal. And we're going to hit that pretty soon. And you guys have been showing mad support as always. And I can't thank you all enough. I always say thank you every video, but it's kind of crazy, you know. I'm gonna end the screen recording real quick, but it's like, I don't know. I've been doing YouTube for a while, and I'm finally starting to see some like really big progress, which is, I don't know, it's dope, you know. A lot of stuff coming up in the next year, end of this year. Like, I don't know. I do not know who that was, but yeah, someone was just talking in my apartment. I'm gonna go check that out. All right, I'll catch you on the next vid. Peace.